The job security of a school nurse has been notoriously fragile. For years, when budget cuts were needed, school nurses were often the first to go. Well, these days, you can make the argument they're needed more than ever. In fact, one group is. They say schools need more than PPE and protocols when classes back in session for in-person learning. They need to make room for school nurses, too.
Schools are going to be spending a lot of money.
A lot of money on changing the way schools used to operate. Lori Combs says the current pandemic has changed everything. Well, almost everything. Combs is the president of the National Association of School Nurses.
The way we practice won't change. It's anticipated that the workload will change.
The workload, because right now there are 130,000 public schools in the United States, K through 12, and 25% of them have no school nurses assigned. The National Association of School Nurses is calling for 10,000 more and $208 billion in federal money to help pay for the added personnel and additional resources like supplies.
10,000 barely meets a third of that need for students and families to have equity in access to high-quality school health.
Combs says the demands on a school will no doubt go up, and school nurses should be considered frontline workers.
School nurses have expertise in public health and infection control processes as they relate to this very unique healthcare setting that's called a school.
What used to be managed in a classroom will send kids straight to the nurse's office in the coming school year, because with COVID-19 still present, anxiety levels will be on the rise as well.
Those students who don't yet have language to express emotion or feel stigma associated with it present with that physical reaction our bodies normally feel.
And school nurses often recognize that trend first. In fact, the School Nurses Association claims before the pandemic, 16% of students needed some sort of mental health intervention. 70% of them got that help at school.
Can you stick your tongue out and say, aw?
More school nurses nationwide, hundreds of billions of dollars to help pay for the added personnel. A big ask when the federal government continues to get squeezed from all sides.
I recognize it's a big ask, but I also hear that in order for the economy to open, schools need to open.
The Safer Return to Schools Coalition requested billions in federal money just 2 weeks ago. The National School Nurses Association is one of the members. It's making its way through the necessary Senate offices in Washington right now, and will it get any traction? School nurses sure hope so, but it's hard to tell. As we all know, the clock is ticking as so many schools continue to struggle with that decision to get students back in the classroom. Julie Unruh, WGN News.